That means this is a top of the line battery. AGM means, what does it mean? Totally forgot. It's a something. What's up, guys? Nate Vincent here with FCP Euro. I have our project car Mk7 GTI behind us, and the time has come to replace the battery. So symptoms of a bad battery are gonna be the car will crank but not start. The car will not crank at all, just click. Other things like this, the reason we're replacing the battery on this car is because there's a serious amount of corrosion around the battery, and we're concerned that the battery case might have cracked a little bit. So whatever your reason may be, this is a very simple project, and I'm gonna walk you through step-by-step on how to replace your own battery. So here we have an Odyssey Group 47 battery. This is the direct replacement battery for the Mk7 Golf. We sell this battery on our site. This is also a top of the line battery. This is an AGM battery, which stands for absorbed glass mat battery. What that means is basically if this side case for any reason gets ruptured, it will not leak fluid out because all of the acid inside this battery is absorbed in little mat. If you're curious about what kind of battery to put in your car, we are going to be putting together a full video on all the different types and styles of batteries and how you know what battery is going to fit your car. Basically, we need two tools. We need a 10 millimeter wrench. You could also use probably a small adjustable if needed. The other thing you're going to need is a 13 millimeter socket and an extension. This makes it very helpful. You can get down there with a wrench if you really want to, but the extension and a socket make it a much easier job, and obviously a ratchet to go along with that. All right, so the first thing we're gonna do is I'm gonna show you the reason why we are actually replacing the battery on this Mk7 Golf. It isn't because the car won't start, and it isn't because the battery doesn't have a charge. It's actually because the battery seems to have cracked and is leaking acid on the battery footing. So let me give you a look of what that looks like and why we're replacing the battery. But first, before I do that, I'm gonna put some rubber gloves on because battery acid is something you do not wanna get on your hands. Rubber gloves going on my fingertips. Rubber gloves going on my fingertips. Right underneath this mat is where the battery lives. So as I pull up on this, I see we're greeted with a series of corrosion all the way around the base of the battery. Near the top, near the terminals, is not bad, but at the bottom is. All right, so the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna disconnect the terminals. That is basically gonna break the battery out of the circuit and stop electricity from flowing through the car and through the battery. So how we do that is we're gonna disconnect the negative side of the terminal first. Honestly, it doesn't really matter which side you disconnect first, but for safety's sake, the negative side, if you touch anything that's grounded on the car, which is pretty much the entire car, you won't get a spark. Whereas if you disconnect the positive side and you touch any part of the car, you'll see a short and a spark. So starting at the negative side, I'm just gonna loosen this pinch bolt up here. We don't need to take it completely loose, but just loosen it. Now in my hand, I'm gonna take it and I'm gonna wiggle this terminal. I can see that it's loose. I'm gonna wiggle it up carefully. Now at this point, the battery is disconnected from the car. That means that we've broken the circuit of electricity. So we're gonna move this negative cable over to the side so that it remains broken and we don't have to worry about the battery reconnecting itself. Now, coming over to the positive side, we're gonna do the exact same thing. And if you're curious, remember the negative symbol is the negative side and the positive symbol, the plus symbol, is the positive side. There's also convention that this one is going to be black or brown and this one will be red. We're gonna pull that off and now the battery is completely disconnected from the car. So there's one pinch bolt that sits right in front of the battery and it actually pushes down on the footing of the battery, and this is where I assume the battery is actually broken. So we're gonna loosen that up and then we're gonna be able to pull the battery out. This is a 13 millimeter bolt that is driven into the battery tray itself, and there's gonna be a sheet metal foot that holds the battery down. So here's the bolt. And then this is the footing, which seems a little stuck in right now because of all the acid around it that holds the battery down. So we're gonna take these both out and we're gonna put them over the workbench. All right, so the next step is we're gonna be muscle man and we're gonna pull this battery out. Remember, this thing weighs about 30 pounds, so it's a little bit heavy. So we're gonna move this off to the side, make sure our terminals are moved off to the side, and we're gonna grab the battery by the handle that's built in, and we're gonna pull it up and out of the car. Ugh. Just like that. So now that we have the battery removed, you can see that clearly there's a lot of acid and debris underneath this battery tray. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go grab a shop vac and I'm gonna suck all this up and prepare the space for the new battery. In our case, we had a lot of battery acid underneath the battery. Another helpful tip aside from vacuuming it out is just use a little bit of hot water on a rag and wipe it down. So the next step we're going to grab the battery and we're going to physically install it. We're not going to hook up the connections yet. So moving the connections to the side to make sure that they don't hit anything. Another thing you can do is you can actually take a rubber glove or a plastic bag and wrap it around the connection just to make sure it doesn't make contact with the battery. Now you want to make sure when you're putting the battery in that you have it located in the same direction. So I know that the positive terminal was forward and the negative terminal was backwards. So I'm making sure that the battery has the same orientation. And now that I'm in, I'm going to slide it back underneath the footing on the back, and then we're going to reinstall the footing on the front. It's removed all the way back. All right, so now that we have the battery placed in the car, we're going to take the foot plate again, and we're going to slide it all the way back. One thing to note is on many BMWs, many Volkswagens, many European cars, there's multiple locations that this foot can mount to. You're going to want to make sure that the battery is slid all the way back in, and the foothold is as close as it possibly can get to the battery, then put the bolt through. So if you look right here, you can see this is the mount for the largest size battery. This is the mount for the middle size battery. And below the battery is actually a hole for the smallest size battery. So you want to make sure that you're not bolting this battery down to the further out mount. So obviously, if we were to mount the battery to this hole, this battery would not actually be mounted. It would be able to free to move. So you really want to make sure that the battery slid all the way back in and the mount is all the way down as close to the battery as possible. Now adding the bolt, I'm going to start the threads by hand to make sure they don't cross-thread. Put a couple turns on it, and now I'm going to grab my 13 millimeter on an extension. I'm going to tighten that down. Right there is tight. We're going to check, make sure the battery is not moving around at all. Make sure it's good and secure. We are going to hook up the positive terminal. So I'm going to pull this cover up. It actually pops off a little bit. Move the cover to the side. We're going to pull the positive terminal around. Now remember, these terminals are actually different size diameters. So this will not mount on the actually this will mount on the negative side, but the negative side won't mount on the positive side. So you really want to make sure you get the orientation correct. Now grabbing my open-ended 10 millimeter wrench, I'm just going to tighten down the positive side of the battery. Remember, the battery is not putting electricity into the car yet because we haven't completed the circuit by connecting the negative side, but we'd still want to be careful once we have the positive side bolted down. Check for tightness, make sure it's not going to wiggle loose, and pop the cap back on if possible. Now on the negative side, there's a little bit of a cover on this. We're going to remove the cover, and we're going to do the same thing. You can see as soon as I made contact with the battery, I heard the electronics in the car start back up again. So now we're going to tighten down this. And there you have it. All right, so now we're going to start the engine and make sure that the battery works. Starting the engine, you can see we have a couple of error codes right here. What we're going to do is we're going to take this car and we're going to drive it around the parking lot, and all of these should go away. Now I'm going to turn it off. We're going to check the clock. So turning the car off, now I'm going to hit the ignition switch without my foot on the brake, just to put two ignition on. Menu, setup, time and date. And since we have it hooked up to GPS, we are at the current time right now. But if you had manual, this is when you would change it manually. All right, so that wraps up our battery install and our Mk7 project car. I hope you found that helpful. A couple little things, we're actually gonna keep this off for a couple of reasons. First, because you can see the battery acid that leaked out of this battery ate up the whole bottom of it. The other reason is because we installed a beautiful AGM battery with a really nice red top, it looks pretty. And the last reason is because AGM in general is more resistant to heat and vibration, so we're not so concerned about having this cover on. That said, if you're putting a regular lead acid battery back in your car, we would highly recommend using this again. So I hope you found this helpful. If you like this video, please hit the thumbs up button. If you want to see more content like this, please subscribe to our channel. And if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. Thanks for watching.